One of the most exciting things about our new curriculum is that we are changing the way we teach.
We're starting students in clinical environments very early, within the first week or two of school.
We shouldn't have a course in which the way in which we teach the students is the same way that I learned when I was in medical school.
HMS has had a long and glorious history of educating physicians, scientists, innovators, and leaders. And one of the secrets of our success has been our ability to evolve our curriculum in response to changes in pedagogy and changes in the external world in which our students will graduate.
Yeah, the big picture of the new curriculum is trying to introduce the basic sciences that students need to know to enter the clinics more quickly.
Most medical schools start with 2 years of preclinical work and then 2 years of clinical work.
And our feeling is that much of the basic science is actually best learned after you've had some clinical experience.
So instead of having a kind of stratified system where you spend 2 years in the classroom and then 2 years in the clinic, the idea is to now interweave these elements.
The core clerkship year, which we're moving from year three to year two, is itself one of the centerpieces of our curriculum. Students go to one of the finest hospitals in the country.
After that principal clinical year, we'll bring everyone back together, the students and the faculty, and we'll be able to take advantage of what they learned during that year, really build upon the experiences they had taking care of patients and interacting with clinicians.
I think you have a greater context for how to really internalize the information that you're being given, why the basic science actually matters when you apply it to a patient case.
Another particularly exciting thing about the new curricular design is the opportunity it will give students in the third and fourth year to individualize their experience.
The idea here is to really give students say in what they learn, in what degree of depth.
So a student who is interested in neurology or psychiatry might very well want and need to take more advanced courses in the pathophysiology of brain disorders.
This curriculum is about the core concepts that you need to function as a doctor, learning those, learning how to think, learning how to apply that at the bedside with your patients. That's the fun part of medicine. That's the stuff that will last with you for your entire career.
I couldn't be more excited about the Pathways curriculum that we will be introducing next year.
Throughout the process of creating this new curriculum, I reflected on my own years at Harvard Medical School, and I'm truly excited by the changes that we're presenting.
We need to incorporate ways of teaching that accept and allow for and highlight the use of new technology.
It's really allowing us to reconceptualize how we think about teaching and really the process of becoming a physician.
I think two real advantages of this change, particularly for the social and population sciences, but really across the whole curriculum, are the efforts and the work that we're doing to integrate all of the right pieces together.
Harvard Medical School is a unique environment to transition from being a pre-medical student to a highly competent physician. We have incredible support for our students here. We have wonderful faculty looking after them both academically and personally, advising them, trying to nurture all of their unique talents toward the career goals they've set for themselves. And we have a lot of fun as we do it as well.